Hi, today is March 28th. I'm Daniel Bogdanoff with Keysight Technologies, and we are giving away another scope today as part of Scope Month. If you follow me on Twitter, you know that I had Kenny Johnson come back in on Friday and pre-record a scope tip for us. He's actually traveling to Taiwan this week, so he came in last Friday to talk about the N2796A. It's a single-ended active probe, really low capacitive loading, 1 picofarad, and pretty high dynamic range, plus or minus 12 volts. So we have a recording of him from Friday that we're going to use as our scope tip today. He actually found a probably an unusual way of using this probe. So by popular demand, I have Kenny Johnson back. He's actually in Taiwan this week. So today's actually Friday. Like I said, we've pre-recorded this, but we wanted to get one more opportunity to have Kenny come on. So Kenny, what do you have for us today?
Okay, so first of all, I've got to apologize for the way I'm dressed today. You know, I said last time that I'm the R&D guy, cleverly disguised as a marketing guy. Well, every now and then I have to shed the marketing gear, go back to R&D gear, because otherwise my old R&D buddies tease me. And that really diminishes my R&D street cred. So today's a little more casual. And if you pay attention, I'm going to go full-on nerd here today. I actually have to use the spectacles for this one. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to share a story. This is going to be a reenactment, but I'm going to share a story about how I used a probe that I designed not long ago to fix not only my iPhone, but several other iPhones within our facility. It goes something like this. You know, you're plugging in your iPhone, you notice it's not charging, right? You're having a hard time. It's like, dang, it's been on there all night. You know, still not charged up. I thought maybe my cable was bad, right? So I got a new cable. My iPhone's still not charging. So what I did was I used this handy probe. This is a single-ended probe. It's our 2796. Designed this a while ago. One of the features we put on there at my request was headlights. And don't know if you can see it light up there on the camera and everything, but it's got headlights on there. Very helpful for guys like me. I didn't eat enough carrots as a kid. The eyesight's not quite as good. So that way I can actually go see those fine pitch parts and see what's going on. Well, I use that probe along with my Dr. Science spectacles. And what I figured out was that I had a whole bunch of toe jam and belly button lint stuck down inside the charger slot. So when the lightning connector goes in there, it just packed it all down in the bottom and it couldn't fully seat itself. So I used the ground pin of the probe and the headlights and my Dr. Science goggles, and I was able to go through and pick out all the belly button lint out of my iPhone, and now it works again. So I thought I was a little bit of a genius. One of our other colleagues, Mike Hoffman down the aisle, his phone croaked the other day. We saved his too, so I thought I'd write a new app note about the probe. Daniel here, though, says that I'd be getting way too much stiff competition from the paperclip. So, you know, I guess if you got a paperclip, you could also do it that way, too. You don't have to use your active probe for that. So that's my tip for today.
Before we do today's drawing, I also want to say that someone was unable to accept the prize. So we're going to do another drawing on April 1st. And we're going to do it April 1st so that you have all the way until midnight, March 31st, to get your entries in. That way we'll do one final scope drawing with all the pool of entries. So let's go ahead and draw today's winner. Today's winner of a 1 gigahertz 3000 T-Series scope is Pawel. I gotta pull the computer up for this one. I apologize. Pawel Porizala. Congratulations, Pawel. We'll be in contact with you. I don't know if I should apologize for that name pronunciation or what. That was pretty bad. As always, make sure you like our Facebook page, subscribe to our YouTube channel, hit the share button below. Thank you for watching. I will see you tomorrow. And if you've never cleaned out the lightning port in your iPhone, it's truly disturbing. So I recommend you do that.
It's like, you know, when the magician is like, you know, pulling that like silk out of his, it's never ending. It's amazing how much stuff comes out. It's horrible.
All right. Well, thanks for being here, Kenny.
Hey, glad I could help.
I hope Taiwan is going well, and we will see you on the blog in the future.
Sounds great.
All right.